If anyone wants to know anything about me, and I don't mean just in a form of filming, but in a conversation, I'd like to assume that I'm talking to a woman that I meet, or perhaps even try to avoid, on an airplane, on a long airplane flight, where usually I refuse to talk to the people next to me, because I do an awful lot of flying, and it's long distance flying, 10, 12 hours. And if you're stuck next to a loquacious person, it's terrible. So I don't even establish eye contact with them. But of course, in a way, I do want to know who's sitting next to me. So every once in a while, perhaps when I get out of the toilet, I quickly look at them here. And sometimes, usually if it's a woman, and if it's an interesting looking woman, I may, in fact, at some later stage while we're eating and so on, start a conversation. And sometimes you have extremely interesting conversation, because this, I say conversation, it's not the sort of monologue that I'll presumably be having today. Because you're sometimes prepared, if you're meeting the right person and it's the right chemistry, and you have to look them in the eye for that, and you're suddenly prepared to talk about things with a stranger, where you know you'll never meet that stranger again, but it's an interesting one, about things that you would not talk to with your family, with your closest intimates, and vice versa. And you sometimes can have conversations which you simply cannot have with someone who's intimate. And that's probably the sort of conversation I'd like to start with, and assume that I'm in an airplane and we've somehow broken through this barrier, and I'm looking at you, and I said, well, this is a woman I would be interested in having a conversation. Now, unfortunately, we're not having a conversation. It'll be sort of a monologue, but whatever it is, I clearly would not start with saying, well, my name is Carl Djerassi, and I was born in Vienna, and my father was a Bulgarian Sephardic Jew, and my mother was a typical Viennese Ashkenazi Jew, and both of them were totally secular, and religion played no role in my life, etc., etc. I wouldn't start that way. See, I've already given you some biographical details, but I would not have started that way, because the rules of the game in this would be that you don't even ask the other person for a name, because you're not going to meet them again. And you have an unfair advantage in that you know who I am, and you've read something about me. And I really want to start with that unfair advantage, which not only you have, but most people who would be interested in me, which may not be that many. But in fact, I've already disclosed as much about my life as I'm ever prepared to disclose. Because I've not just written one autobiography, I've not just written two autobiographies, I've in fact written three autobiographies. And you think, my God, is this man either a total exhibitionist, because the autobiography has to be an exhibitionist. You have to undress. You have to be prepared to undress. But of course, I'm not willing to strip naked. So that's all been written already, and I'm, in a way, I don't really know why I should make it easier for the for the lazy person. If they're interested in me, go to the library and read it, or since these books are still in print, go buy it and read it at your leisure. But of course, that's not the purpose of this. I may nevertheless every once in a while refer to them here, not only as a book-selling author, but rather to sort of, not even refresh my memory, but to see something in terms of organization, or perhaps even make a point.